Although commonplace today, the landscape as a distinct category in painting only really began to establish itself in Western art during the Renaissance, a period in which natural views began to make their way to the fore of focus, no longer merely backgrounds to human figures. Perhaps an interesting quirk of this transition were the images which seemed to fuse the two, anthropomorphic landscapes. These images, particularly where landscapes are given the form of human heads, appear to be somewhat of a meme of the 17th century, with examples cropping up again and again, especially in Netherlandish painting. Below we've compiled a collection of such images available online, sadly not all of them openly licensed, with a big debt owed to a great post on JS blog which provided a wonderful springboard for our findings. One of the most popular versions of the anthropomorphic landscape is the depiction of a bearded man, horizontal in rocky profile. The beginnings of this can be traced back to an image created by the great 17th century polymath Athanasius Kircher, featured in his Ars Magna Lucis et Umbri, 1645-6. Kircher's design is said to have been inspired by a story related by Vitruvius about the 4th century BC architect Dinocrates' plan to sculpt into Mount Athos a colossal image of Alexander the Great, who would hold a small city in one hand and with the other pour a river into a sea by means of a gigantic pitcher. Kircher's more modest rendering, involving only a face rather than full body, was to be copied and riffed upon many times over the next decades, including by Wenceslas Hollar, who in his rendition trims the beard and hair for a general smarter appearance. With the following two images we depart a little from the profile aspect of Kircher's design. The engravings are by the German artist Johann Martin Will, 1727-1806, who made many such images. The Asia one is part of a larger series in which each continent is represented as a face embedded into a landscape. See a very low res version of the Europa one here. Like Jews de Mumper, coming up, Will also created a similar series for each of the seasons. There follow a few more examples of this horizontal face in the rock motif, including another by Johann Martin Will. The Herremetsdubbel's painting, which dates from around 1550, is the earliest example we can find of hiding a face in a landscape, predating Kircher's image by a whole century. The face is subtle, but it definitely there. A little jump ahead in time with the next image, a demonstration of the anthropomorphic landscape's importance in the popular German Vexia Bild, image puzzle, of the 19th century. This particular one is an advert for Dr. August Koenig's Hamburger Tropfen, a medicine said to be effective against all sicknesses of the stomach, liver, and abdomen. Titled Das Picnic, the writing below reads Wo ist der Mann? Welch ist Dr. August Koenig's Hamburger Tropfen gebraucht? Where is the man who always needs Dr. August Koenig's Hamburg drops? The following three images, in which the hidden face is now upright, are from Jules de Mumper's series Anthropomorphizing the Four Seasons. We can only find a fairly low res one for spring, see here. There is no exact date for these, but they are thought to be from the early 17th century. Mumper died in 1635, so would have predated Kircher's bearded man by a good decade at the very least. The next two continue with the hidden head in an upright position, both using the anthropomorphic element to emphasize a certain humanness. The first an illustration of our five senses, the second, which is an allegory of iconoclasm, in the idea perhaps of putting the human form before God. The next picture is an illustration by Henry Holliday for Lewis Carroll's The Hunting of the Snark. The face hidden in the darkness of the trees is thought by some to be based on J. Hutt's iconoclasm image above, as well as landscapes. Faces were often composed of buildings and combinations of other structures and figures. The next image shows a sketch, an allegory of death, attributed to that great master of the composite portrait Giuseppe Arsimboldo, 1526-1593. Following this is an image, very likely to be a direct adaptation of Arsimboldo's, found in Veridicus Christianus, 1601, the very first Jesuit emblem book. The final image shows a popular motif, in the aforementioned German Vexia build tradition, in which elements so full of life combine to create a memento mori image of a skull.